I believe there's emphasis that needs to be placed more on having a spiritual discernment, which a lot of people are not really familiar with. You rely on things that you could see. Jesus Christ even said, the first principle, listen, before he healed anyone, he said, do you believe? You know, if the people then had to rely on things that they can only see, Jesus wouldn't have done a miracle. He said, first, do you believe?
Which, where do you get that from?
Well, when you read the New Testament, in terms of what Jesus Christ did and before he performed these miracles, Jesus Christ, he always wanted to test people's
faith. Do you remember the Samaritan woman?
I do.
Did he ask her, do you believe?
Sure, let's get into that.
Need I say more?
No, sure, let's get into that.
Yes.
Let's explore that.
So answer the question. Did he ask her, do you believe?
No, he didn't ask.
Good, so you're wrong.
No, wait a minute.
What did he say? Can we clarify?
So the Samaritan woman, Jesus Christ had come on a particular mission. He'd come for a specific reason.
Which is?
Yeah, which is to come...
specific people, wait, can we say that?
No, let him say it.
Please.
I want him to say it.
Sorry. Please.
What was his specific mission?
There's a specific order in which Jesus had to fulfill.
Order?
Absolutely.
Are those your words or Jesus' words?
Well, from what Jesus Christ said and what he did, it would seem so.
What did he say? I'm interested in that. Sure. What did he say?
So he said, I have come for the lost...
I have not come. Except?
Except for the lost...
sheep of Israel.
Sheep of Israel.
Yes.
Which is fine. Jesus Christ said he didn't come to himself, he'd been sent to the Father, which means that's the Father's will. The Father's will is that he'd save the lost sheep of Israel first, and then the good news of him saving the lost sheep of Israel goes out to the Gentiles.
Who said that?
That's what happened.
No, I'm asking you, who said that?
I'm just saying that's according to the New Testament. That's
because in fact, he told not to go into the locality, I'm paraphrasing, of the Gentiles. Did he not say that?
Not yet.
Don't go amongst the Gentiles.
Why? Because Jesus Christ had to first, like he said, I'm paraphrasing, save the lost sheep of Israel. The lost sheep of Israel. Now that's dealing with the Jews that were there. He was Jewish himself, and he came to save those people, not only to save the rest of the world, but there was an order in which his work would be done. He first came to the Jews, and then the good news of him saving and redeeming mankind was to go out to the Gentiles.
Where is that in the Bible? Where did he say to go out amongst the Gentiles?
In the Bible.
Yeah. Did Jesus say that?
Jesus said that.
Where did he say it?
Jesus said
Let's
that.
Read that. That's why, you know, I'm not trying to be difficult. I like to substantiate what people say. That's all I'm saying.
Very good. Let's do it.
Because I want to know if Paul said it or Jesus said it.